Sir, with your permission, I would like to post the queries that have been raised by the participants. Yes, sir. The first question is from one Mr. Girish Kumar. Sir, to what category of products GI is applicable?
Yeah, Mr. Girish, thanks for the question. So, geographical indication in India, the GI Act, the geographical indication of goods, is pertaining to agricultural products, even handicrafts, handlooms, all types of similar products. Even as I told, mirrored scissors. The scissors is a kind of a tool for which we use in our daily life. And Meerut in Uttar Pradesh is a traditional scissor making cluster. They make the tools from scrap iron, from especially from railways. So that is a very interesting product. And you can see most of the tailors, they use this scissors from Meerut. They find it is quite different from other normal scissors which we use. With the and they find it quite to their comfort, the operating comfort, and all other things which be required by the tailoring people who are in the tailoring industry. So likewise, so many products come to mind, but except live animals, which as of now do not form a product of I mean, a subject matter of geographical indications due to some reasons which I do not want to delve at length as of now. All other products are eligible to the product should have some connection with the place and some history. That's it. Any local history, some factors, regional factors which influence. So that is the key element for claiming a geographical indication tag. Hope I have answered the question. Next, please.
Next question by one Mr. Shiva. Is it possible to get GI for the newly invented or created product for a particular group of people?
But I'm really wondering, I mean, question is particular group of people means it, as we call, there should be some linkage. In there is a French word called terroir, TERVOIR. That's called, I mean, the pronunciation may be different. There should be some linkage between the place and the product. For example, any product we used to come across, if our Hyderabad Haleem, I should say, what we the clinching evidence was so many papers and other things which in detail explained about the linkage of Hyderabad with Haleem. But the skill of the local people, Hyderabad Haleem as such originated from Iran and came to the Hyderabad, this local flavor of Telangana, the spices. Gave a new version to the Haleem. Of course, good tasters of Haleem may be able to tell this. So that is the that should be the there should be some linkage to be established. That is the real funda behind grant of geographical indication. So he has told about a group of people making a new product. Why cannot it be a patent? So that should be. There should be some kind of heritage behind it, at least to some meaningful period of time. That should be a key element. These are all the key elements. So some chemistry between the local land and the people, likewise. So all these elements put together form a what do you call an aspect for claiming geographical indication.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, on that note, can you just highlight the difference between a patent and a GI, sir? Because you just dealt with it in a simple way.
Yeah, you see, patent is granted on various categories, yes, by the way, the global level as well as the Indian level. Patent is granted for a product which is novel, non-obviousness, non-obvious and having industrial applicability. Whereas geographical indication is totally different. It is part of a community rights and it a kind of an accreditation given to a product. Originating from a particular source, a geographical area. That's why we say longitude and latitude are very much important. So that is the real key element for a geographical indication, which has some heritage attachment, the particular place and product. That's really, you link the place and product, you get the geographical indication. Whereas a patent is a different ball game.
Yes, thank you, sir. Next question by Dr. Vijay Kalyani. Sir, I had a slight doubt. As I am not much aware of implementation of GI Act in India, can the GI tags help in empowering and protecting traditional knowledge of our country?
TKs. Yeah, definitely. That's a clear to the one of the best tool known so far to foster the traditional knowledge in India has been geographical indication. In my opinion, experience, that has been a very clear. Even I had presented a paper with my friend Subhajit Saha. Of course, Dr. G.P. Reddy knows him well. We have presented a paper in which that was in the year 2015. The IIT Roorkee, organized a symposium on fostering traditional knowledge. And the paper which we gave was the GI is one of the best tool to foster traditional knowledge. Otherwise, just registering TKDL, traditional knowledge, digital library is there by WIPO. But these are all just preliminary steps to make a traditional knowledge vibrant as a vibrant economy model. Ultimately, you should sell the product in the market. There should be some USP. And these USPs are very well carried out by the GI tag, which has been very clearly established in Europe, as well as this trend is starting in India. The heartening news is that GI tag products getting premium price. So GI is a very good tool.
Yeah. Next question by one Mr. Rajaswamy. Production of a good and marketing of it in other locations. In this situation, how many places can do GI tag? Like how to make it export level with GI tag?
Yeah, definitely. Well, this, I think this question I saw even in this chat box. See, export market is totally, a GI product definitely has immense potential within the country as well as abroad. As I told, the Indian people, Indian diaspora settled outside. In outside India, they are the biggest ambassadors of Indian product, and the demand is more. If, for example, even the classic case of Hyderabad Aleem in places like UK, in London as well as US. But of course, there are a lot of challenges in taking these products because the meat laws, there is a different, every country has got its own meat laws. And you cannot just ship it from Hyderabad to, from an Indian port to other countries. So we have to obey to the other, even biodiversity laws for agricultural products. Okay, we have so many banana varieties in India registered as a GI, but it's next to impossible to take to certain countries which value their biodiversity too very much. Because I heard in some countries, even the degree of offense of carrying narcotics is lesser. But if you carry a biodiversity material to the without the knowledge of the country, or you are held in that port, that will be treated as a more serious offense, because those countries want to protect their biodiversity. They do not want agri product landing in their ports and someone starts cultivating. That will totally create a confusion, and their biodiversity will get spoiled. Of course, biodiversity resources from foreign that is well known. In India also, we hear stories like the Parthenium weeds is nothing but an import from 1960s from the wheat which we got as a gift from US or some other countries. So the Parthenium weeds, so that's nowadays many countries have tightened their belts for this kind of imposing very strict curbs on biodiversity products. So when it comes to import and export, a lot of challenges. That's why there can be some bilateral agreements between countries. Say, for example, Haleem is so popular in London, means India and UK can give they can income bilateral MOUs to respect each other's GIs. That can be one good scenario to import foster exports.
Next question by Mr. Ritvik. Sir, what is the validity of GI and where would the disputes be resolved in case of any dispute over GI tax between two states in India?
I think he's a practitioner. I believe he's budding. GI registered is in India is valid for 10 years and that can be renewed, of course, on payment of renewal. So it is a perpetual intellectual property. Of course, after registering a GA, there are the people who are involved in the manufacture can register themselves as authorized users. So they can use the GA tag in their cartons or whatever promotional material, whatever it may be. So that is how the system for GA functions. So the GA is a perpetual.
He also asks, where would the disputes be resolved?
Disputes, I must say, till last year, the Intellectual Property Appellate Board located in Chennai was, and it has been having sittings in Delhi, was dealing with it. But now the Intellectual Property Appellate Board has been removed and quashed by an order of Government of India. So now the GI related disputes are dealt with the concerned courts, high courts, as well as the apex court. Before that, till last year, the IPAB.
Next question by Ammu. Sir, the geographical indication like Aranmula, Kannadi, Kanchipuram, Pattu Sari, there are so many duplicate products available in the market as same as the original products. Those come under the geographical indication. It is very evident and till now this duplication is happening. Is there any effective way to restrict this duplication?
A very pertinent question she has asked related to Aranmula mirror. I know I have studied the geographical indication. It is very much very confined to a very small geographical territory of Pathanamthitta Aranmula in Pathanamthitta district of Kerala, and that too it is practiced by a few people who have migrated from Tamil Nadu, few artisans who are well versed in the alchemy, I should say alchemy, or in the ancient chemical processing. It is nothing, this is very beautiful mirror which has nothing to do with our quartz or silicon based. Normally the mirrors which we have, given that the Aranmula mirror has got nothing to do with quartz or whatever it may be. Normally the mirror which we use is a kind of an amalgam, I should say, the mercury compound is pasted on the backside of a mirror to improve its reflection abilities, reflecting abilities. But this Aranmula mirror is nothing but a polished metal. Of course, any metal which we use, we use the tumblers or in which our faces get it reflected. But that's not a very poor reflection, I should say. Our faces may look funny in those. But this mirror exactly replicates your image when you see through it. And that is the age-old tradition carried out by these artisans, metal craftsmen in Aranmula. It is hardly some 25 to 30 families are living, but it's very costly product. If you want to purchase the original Aranmula piece of mirror, it should cost you around 7,000, I believe. It's, I think, the Kerala State Handicrafts, Kairali, they too sell in very select emporiums. This Aranmula mirror and even made to order like that. So when it comes to duplication, I think they may be using some inferior metals or inferior chemicals, compounds. And ultimately what happens, the Aranmula mirror, the name itself gets spoiled. Some by using some kind of nondescript and nonsensical stuff done by this. So they're creating the downfall of their entire. So tomorrow somebody sees an Aranmula mirror, is the image which he has and sees a funny face instead of his original face, and then he will be totally disillusioned by the Aranmula mirror and he may start negative campaigning. So to stop this, the manufacturer should have very tight grips. That's what I used to emphasize on code of practice. Otherwise that will become a total nuksan ho jayega, total product will get spoiled. So you cannot expect the GA enforcing author, I mean, GA registry and all to come to play a big role in this. Post GA, there should be watchdog mechanism to upkeep the tradition of the product and the cultural linkages it is having, so that the clientele and the customers are always aware. So GA is a tool which is, that's what we used to say, it's a tool which helps the producer as well as the consumer. So the consumer should be aware of all this, how when he is going to purchase the GA tag and all, if it is used very prominently, he can be assured that he is not duped by spurious products, and his hard-earned money is not cheated for some such products. So
next question by one Mr. Riaz. Indian granites have multiple qualities and they are being exported to other countries. Does the same qualify under GI granite?
Some stones and semi-precious stones like that, and even granites, the marble of Makrana. We used to know that even the our famous Indian edifice Taj Mahal is being was created by the marbles from Makrana in Rajasthan. That is, Makrana is near Ajmer, I believe. And of course, Agra is located some 300 kilometers or maybe roughly 200 plus from the place in Rajasthan. Agra is in Uttar Pradesh. So in those days itself, the marble slabs were carried by camels or whatever it may be, painstakingly from Makrana to Agra. So that is the, that's what we, when we go through the history of construction of Taj Mahal. So that being the case, Makrana marble is already registered GA. So that's how they create a product and process linkage and a history behind it. In case of such granites, which he says, if he's able to produce such evidence, and definitely GA, there is maybe some element of a GA case which can be taken to the GA registry. Even I had visited few clusters near the place called Morena in Madhya Pradesh, which is goes on the way from Gwalior to Delhi, a place called Morena. They have some sandstone cluster. They were really interested and to establish that the greenstone mined and quarried in that region has got some traditional and a specificity of the region. So that was one of its kind I came across. So that's how, if you are able to establish and you have some evidence, then you can build up GA case.
The next question by Ms. Alaka Samal. Sir, if a man from Hyderabad starts Haleem business in any other place in India and sells in the name Hyderabad Haleem, will it amount to infringement of GI?
That
is the right of that man confined only to Hyderabad.
Yeah, strictly speaking, Haleem, which is made in Hyderabad, and which is, I must say, 78 degrees latitude, I'm so particular about this. That is the real, which is confined to this, and is a member of the Haleem Makers Association, which is, and he is ready to follow all these norms. It's advised as of now to call it as a Hyderabadi Haleem. Otherwise, if he is making in a place, especially the place which expropriates this Hyderabad Haleem more, is Bangalore. It's been found out. Bangalore is a city which is much fond of Hyderabad Haleem, even more than Hyderabad. It's being sold in and Bombay to a certain extent, and Delhi maybe, and even Chennai in other places. So there is. It is, as of now, it is better for them to call it as Haleem and not use it as Hyderabad Haleem. But then if he is so particular, then there can be amendments to the statement of case or code of practice. So within, he should maintain all the specifications as given in the code of the SOC statement of case. Then there can be relaxation. As of now, there is no such thing existing. So he can call it as Haleem. But not as Hyderabad Haleem.
Next question by one Mr. Mopur Prasad. Sir, as per your talk, there is no GA for animals. Is it possible to have geographical indication to sports? If not now, in future. He has Jallikattu in mind.
Yeah. Yeah, correct, correct. And even Kalaripayat and whatever, and even Ayurvedic forms of all these things have been discussed. So these are all traditional form of games, likewise. And they are not, see, as of now, if you see the geographical indication, it is geographical indication act for goods. So goods is a very clear word as of now. So that is why even animals are not part of goods. Animals are living species. They are not part of goods. Likewise, even the forms of sport, Jallikattu, or even whatever it may be, even Kalari from Kerala, or Silambattam, of course, a form of martial art in Tamil Nadu. All these things can't be part of geographical indication unless otherwise they make an amendment and make provisions for including these sports forms. But of course, what is the actual commercial benefit out of it? I would like to ask a question to that person. By registering it, what is the commercial benefit? Means only this, the practitioners with only GA registered will, after registering themselves, should be able to teach, or are considered to be the appropriate people to teach, and they can gain some benefit. I would like to know from this person what is the purpose of seeking a GA if an amendment is made. So I'm just, with all freedom, I'm throwing back the question to you.
Yes, sir. If there is any response, I will update you, sir, in the meantime. The next question from Mr. Ram Mohan Rao, Hanchati Ram Mohan Rao. Sir, could you clarify whether GI extend to animate or inanimate things, and whether GI and patent both are global or local? I think this is already answered. Yeah. Sir.
So GI is a sui generis. As of now, the system is called sui generis, means evolved on its own. Of course, Dr. G.B. Reddy may be able to explain it further. It's a sui generis system we have. We are not part of any protocols, the Lisbon Protocol or whatever it may be. We are not part of any. As when it comes to patent, we are a part of, India is a part of this PCT, Patent Cooperation Treaty. But we are not any member of such GA protocols. We can file, we accept, India accepts applications from GA applications from foreign countries in the conventional method. We have so many products like champagne, well discussed champagne or scotch whiskey, so many products, Napa Valley wine from US, and all these European, a host of GA products from Europe have filed their GA applications, and they have been granted, but it's done in the conventional system. That is, there is no such a system, harmonizing system as they exist in case of patents or trademarks. The trademarks are governed by the Madrid Protocol, like that. India is not a part of that GA system.
Sir, next question by Sujata Mahajan. Can the right to use registered GI transfer like other IPs easily?
No, non-transferable. GI is a very good question she has asked. Very clearly stated, it is non-transferable. You have a patent, you can license it, you can even mortgage it, do whatever it may, even barter it or whatever you do. You may have a technology, but you may not be interested to manufacture it. You find a good partner who is ready to invest on it, and the product, you can enter into an agreement, whatever it may be. But in case of GA, it's not. It's given after very careful scrutiny of who the applicants are, and do the applicant clearly serve the interest of the people involved in the community, and they are located in the address of the manufacturing place where the GA is hails from. All these aspects are taken into due consideration. Then only it's granted. And so there is no scope of transferring GI rights.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Can a GI tag be revoked? And if yes, under what circumstances and how?
Yeah, revocation of GI tag comes. I think it has occurred in one case, I believe, this Payyanur Pavitra Modram, which is a kind of a ring, a golden ring, which is manufactured from this north in the Malabar, near Talasheri, I believe, in Kerala. The ring, golden rings, was they originally got a GI tag, but later, due to some reasons, I think if the person is interested, he can go through the IPAB site as on what grounds it was rejected. Revoked, I should say, not rejection is can be done. Many of the GA applications has been rejected in the stage of scrutiny itself, but this is a case of revocation that has been done due to some irregularities found with the applicant. So I believe so revocation is possible, but very in very it comes in very once rare occasions, not regular feature revocation of a GA. But there are instances in which GA applications have been refused by the GA registry on various grounds.
Thank you, sir. Next question by Trichy Sundar. Does Turmeric have GI tag? Already it has been patented, like there has been issues surrounding Turmeric. Probably she won't.
I would like to reply to my dear friend Sundar that Ero Turmeric has been granted a geographical indication tag, and the turmeric cultivated in the regions of Composite Coimbatore, which was Erode, is a part of it, and it's the area spreads to these two districts in Tamil Nadu. The turmeric cultivated due to the presence of curcumin, that is an important ingredient in turmeric and other properties, the turmeric has been granted a GI tag. I think the grant was given some 2 to 3 years before. It's a really fillip to the cultivators, and they can, I wish the manufacturers take this turmeric. And of course, even there are efforts, there are so many turmeric which have been granted a GA tag, especially I hear from Orissa, the Kandamal region, the curcumin content is very high in that the turmeric cultivated by the tribals there, and it's confined to very less. I think even Ero turmeric, the geographical spread is from Ero to Coimbatore, so it's a very high, good area of spread. But this Kandamal is confined to very few tribal farmers. And even Nizamabad in Andhra Pradesh, I mean, presently Telangana, there are efforts to secure the GA rights. Wygaon turmeric, my good friend Mr. Ganesh Ingmire, I hope you have, many of you in the GA, interested GA enthusiasts might have heard his name, Mr. Ganesh Ingmire from Pune. He has been filed so many agri products, and Wygaon turmeric from Vidarbha region have sought a GA.
And I thank you, sir. Next question by Sridhar Sivaraman. How GI will reach the poor people? No poor people are aware of this, like Manapparai, Murukku, Tirunelveli, Halwa.
Yeah, of course.
So what can be
purpose
done?
Purpose of, I don't want, would not like to use the word poor. Let me say less privileged or like that. The purpose of geographical indication itself is to foster the local growth of a product. See, the Manapparai, Murukku, which he has mentioned, which I had the opportunity of tasting it last month after so many decades, that has a connection with the railway station, which is located between Madurai and Tiruchirappalli, especially Dindigul and Tiruchirappalli especially. So that product, the region Manapparai itself is water starved. Of course, though it is located some 40 kilometers from Trichy, where the perennial Kaveri flows, this region is a pretty dry area. And the that they have converted that dry, less availability of water. The water itself has got more saline content. And the Murukku, the chaklis, Murukku is called chaklis in the north. It's a they prepared with that water in combination gives a specific taste. And that taste, it was sold in the station. That has been given very clearly in the statement of case. So that has been a revelation, and the product is so popular in Tamil Nadu, and even many people who have migrated to various countries, they are still fond of this type of, especially from Trichy, Dindigul region. They are so fond of this product, and they even want to order it from US or UK, where they have now settled. It's because they have a small specific affinity towards this product. So that's how these poor people, poor manufacturers can gain advantage by using appropriate e-commerce platforms, so that their product goes from local to global. So this is one good tool, so that the customer also, the end customer, can be rest assured that he is not duped by any other products, who other people who say sitting from Chennai or other places or Coimbatore, they sell this as Manapare Murukku. They can be rest assured they can purchase the authorized users of GA tag, so that they can enjoy this snack which they enjoyed in their young age.
Sir, the last question, sir. Sir, there is a follow-up from the earlier person, Mr. Mukur Prasad, regarding the GA for sports. His perspective is it can be commercialized by advertisements during the event and broadcast rights, etc.
Yeah, if he is confident, then definitely policy makers, GA practitioners and all people can make a plea to the DPIIT, and there should be, I don't know, I mean, has there been any efforts to amend the GA Act? I think our professor can tell, throw more light on this. If the need arises to include such games or traditional, and it would serve as an advertisement, definitely there is ample scope to include. Now, recently in the European scenario, I came to know about this Black Forest, this German delicacy. As we know, if we hit into any bakery, we find the Black Forest pastry or cake being sold. The Black Forest is, they have introduced as TSG, as a traditional specific specialty guaranteed. TSG is a new form of emerging methodology to grant GA kind of status to such products. So that has been a new effort.
Last question, sir, from Abhilasha Ravi. Can a company or institution claim complete ownership over a GA? For example, can the Tirupati temple claim a GI over the renowned Tirupati laddu?
Yeah, Abhilash, you have asked a very pertinent query here. The question of granting GIs to this such temple prasadams, especially Tirupati laddu, which is the most sought after prasadam in India for any temple, was a kind of a dubious decision. I don't want to delve more into, because now it is a granted GI. I think there is specifically the who has applied for this GI is none other than the TTD, Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanams, the body which controls entire operations and aspects of the Tirupati temple, the most sort of a revered temple for Hindus in India, maybe the entire world. So the reason for granting the GA status for Tirupati laddu is not a commercial product. I can say it is I agree, it is a token of reverence to the Lord. After a person, a devotee worships the Lord and he purchases. Of course, I think nowadays, earlier there used to be some two laddus used to be given as a prasadam. So now a lot of other, he would like to purchase the product and give it to his kith and kin, whoever it may be, and friends as a token of that is the, when it comes to such scenario, there has been situations where some sweetmeat makers, and especially there is a case in Chennai on Ganga Sweets, he manufactured and he sold a Sirupati laddu. So that became a very, TTD was, some people found, this is very much hurting. It is, I mean, a kind of, how can you claim a prasadam's name and you commercialize it and you sell it for a premium price? So that prompted them to initiate a case, and they were advised to remove the Tirupati tag from the laddus they were manufacturing. So, and of course, a TTD does not make, TTD is a commercial, is not a commercial organization as such. It is established by an act by, of course, the Andhra Pradesh government to manage the affairs of the temple premises from various, because it is a very huge area, visited by so many devotees all over the world, and so to it is the TTD is streamlining entire operations, including the distribution of the prasadam. So they have sought a GA rights to safeguard it from being from others being duped by spurious. So it is one of the, I think, the smallest area of geographical area for a GA with longitude and latitude is TTD, the Tirupati Laddu. It's not even even the, I should say, Tirumala is that the Potu canteen is the only place which is the manufacturing area for the GA product. Otherwise, even you cannot manufacture it in any other place, even the SV University or whatever it may be. No, you cannot, the places near SV University or any place in Tirupati should not manufacture. It cannot be called as a Tirupati.
So we have received about 18 queries, sir, and you have been patient and answered the queries in a detailed manner for about 45 minutes. Thank you so much, sir. This was the longest Q&A session till now. Now I request DPIT Chair Professor, yeah, Professor G.B. Reddy Garu, to...
Privilege is mine also. Thanks a lot for... of course, it's a very big topic. It is never ending. Thanks for the patient hearing, and the opportunity given by my good friend Dr. G.B. Reddy is really worthwhile mentioning.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Ravi. And in fact, as Dr. Irfan said, this has been the longest Q&A session among the five lectures we have organized so far. It has been a privilege, hearing Mr. Ravi's presentation, because that's what exhibits the expertise the resource person has in this particular area. And most of the questions are practical. They are not really, learned in a classroom ambience. Only a person who practically deals with those areas in GA offices or in IPAB, etc., can answer such questions in such a nice and clear manner. For the information, just to sum up and supplement what the experts said, not to substitute, only to supplement here and there. There are 417 GIs registered so far. More than 675 applications have been filed, out of which 417 GIs have been registered. And South India also is leading, especially two or three states, including Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Kerala. Then about the poor people, probably Mr. Ravi would call them less privileged. They have so many opportunities, provided their goods qualify for registration as GI. And CII has been conducting GI roadshows, and other organizations are also doing the same. Awareness levels have to be built in order to enable them to protect their GIs. And as Mr. Ravi said, it is a sui generis system. In the European Union, it is a community trademark. In fact, it's not called a GI. So it is their way of registering their, appellations of origins. Even though we have a Lisbon Agreement of 1958, India has not signed. So Geneva Act of 2005, these two are occupying the field, but India is not a party. In that sense, again, we have to rely only upon the TRIPS Agreement and the GI Act of 1999 with effect from 2003. Then about the difference between patent and GI, Mr. Ravi has explained very well, because one is a collective property with perpetual protection if registration is continued, like champagne or Roquefort cheese or whatever it is. But patent has a limited shelf life, and it can end within 20 years. And of course, the system altogether is different. Benefit sharing is yet to be ensured. I think in India, we have to take care of this. There are few successful models. There are few models which are failures also, like TBGRI model for Jeevani in Kerala. They tried, but somehow GI could not be registered. Stakeholders were not happy. That still continues. Then about the Jallikattu and sports, Mr. Ravi has very clearly clarified the fact that GIs are registered only in case of goods. So natural, manufactured, or agricultural. Sports can never be the subject matter of GI protection. Of course, the material used in the sports. For example, the cricket bat is made of a particular kind of wood. If that is available in a particular area, which is having unique characteristics because of the geographical factors, certainly it might qualify for GI. But not the sport itself. I'm talking about only the goods. This is one important aspect, sir. And I think you have explained so well that there are number of questions asking for your email ID and mobile number also. And Dr. Irfan has already shared once. If you permit, whoever asks will get all the details like your contact number as well as the mail ID. The only request is kindly don't bombard Mr. Ravi with your academic questions and all. If you need any kind of professional guidance, assistance, whatever, I think it will combine both the pleasure as well as the duty. This is the only request. And I'm very happy that even on the day of Pongal, Sankranti, whatever, so many people have remained online and ultimately exhibited so much, you know, enthusiasm to learn about this particular aspect. Sir, if Hyderabadi Haleem is over, then Nizamabad Natukodi is waiting. Nizamabad Turmeric is waiting. There are so many. So I suggest to all the members to search, then to approach Mr. Ravi. I think he would be very happy to assist us in a professional manner also to register these GIs. So these are a few comments from our side.